Hey there, my name is Andy O'Neill, and in this co-build tip video, I'm going to show you how to find the start and end dates for a week given any date of that week. The idea here is you have a date and you need to figure out what day was Sunday for that week and what day was Saturday. So what's the first day of the week and the last day of the week for any given date? I've got a two-module scenario just to illustrate this, and I've got my input date. So it's currently November 19th, 2023, and so I'm going to enter in the 22nd, which is a Wednesday. This scenario is going to find Sunday of this week and Saturday, so the first and last days of the week. All right, so in this scenario, I've got a few things in here. I'll show you what this is. But really, here's the Sunday date, and here's the Saturday date. We're going to look at those formulas a little more closely, but let's run this. And you can see my input date is the 22nd. So I've set some variables here. There's my 22nd. So the input day of the week is Wednesday. So that is the day of the 22nd. So if we go check our calendar, we see the 22nd is Wednesday. And I've used a formula to figure that out. So we need to figure out how many days we need to get from Wednesday to Sunday. So that number is 3. So we're going to say subtract 3 days from today, because today is Wednesday, and that gives us November 19th. And then we have to say, how many days do we need to add to get to Saturday's date? So that's also 3, because we're in the middle of the week on Wednesday. So to get to Saturday, we need to go 1, 2, 3 into the future. And to get to Sunday, we need to go 1, 2, 3 into the past. So that is how we do that. And I'm using a formula here that tells us what day of the week it is and helps with our math. So let me test this again for you. So let me do the 20th, which would be a Monday. And I'm going to run that. I just want to show you that this is working correctly. So here's our date. That's a Monday. So how many days do we need to subtract to get to Sunday? Well, we just need to subtract 1. All right. To get from Monday to the previous day is 1. And then to get to Saturday's date, we need to add 5. So if we're on Monday, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 gets us to Saturday. So that's how this works. So let me show you this formula. I'm going to go down here to Sunday's date right here. And this formula looks a little scary. We've got some nested formulas in here. So what I'm doing is I'm formatting the date. So I'm taking that date from the previous module, I'm mapping it here, and I'm just formatting it in the format that I want. Now, what I have to do is I have to subtract the number of days to get from the current date to Sunday. So I'm doing an add days formula here. And so in the add days formula, you put your date in, which is here, and then you put the number you want to subtract. In this case, I'm using a formula to subtract that number. So I'm putting a negative, and I'm using current date, and I'm using this D variable. Now, if we go over here to the tokens for date and time, D, what that does is it gives you the day of the week from 0 to 6. Now, there is another one here. There's a capital E that gives you the day of the week 1 to 7. We don't want that because that would throw our math off. So what this is going to do is it's going to say format date. So take the current date and format that as a 0 to 6. So for Sunday's date, if we go back here, what this formula is saying, Monday is the day of the week. So if we want to go from Monday to Sunday, we're going to subtract 1. So for Saturday's date, we're doing the same thing. We're doing an add days, except in this case, we're saying 6 minus whatever the day of the week number is. We're saying Monday is the second day of the week, and in our formatting, Sunday is actually 0 and Monday is 1. So that's why this works. So Monday equals 1. So we're saying 6 minus 1 equals 5. And that's how you get moving the date forward 5 days to give you Saturday's date. Now, I feel like this is getting fairly complicated. What I want to let you know is if you want to use this, simply use this formula here and this formula here. If you're interested in looking at these formulas, there'll be a link in the description where you can see these formulas, and I will describe them and explain what they're doing on my website in a little more detail than what I can do here on YouTube.